Welcome to Snowrunner. So, we are back at it. Snowrunner hard mode here. I got a plan. We're going to do a bunch of contracts in Black River, and we're going to steal a bunch of fuel. So, so to start off, I'm going to grab the White Western Star, and we're going to... Actually, I'm going to use the Fleet Star, and we are going to nab this fuel carrier trailer, our fuel trailer, and we're going to take that into Black River, along with my new fuel truck and the White Western Star. So that's what we're going to start. And so the goal today is we're going to do a bunch of contracts in Black River and basically try to clear up the map a little bit. But we got to steal some fuel first. So that is what we are on our way to do. How's everybody doing today? You guys having a good day? I'm having a great day so far. It is Thursday, and we are doing some trucking. All right, in the Black River with the fuel. And the fuel convoy is away. Alright, so we're gonna head over. There's a fuel station in Black River on the other side of the lake. We're gonna head over there and we're gonna steal all the fuel out of the fuel station. Because there's a big fuel tanker there that we gotta move. That's for this contract here pipe dream. We gotta move this heavy fuel tanker semi trailer. So we are gonna be moving that with the White Western Star. So we're gonna have to bring that truck into this map so we can move that. But I want to get as much of the fuel out of that as we can, because once we do that contract, that's going to start opening up a bunch of the other contracts in Michigan, so we can start really progressing in the map, because that's going to give us a ton of XP as well. And hopefully by the end of today we'll hit rank 8. I think we need 1200 XP to get to rank 8. Because once we get to rank 8, we'll have the off-road tires, and then we'll be able to get a lot of stuff done that way with the off-road tires. Because that will actually open up. We might be able to start chipping away at the logging, maybe, once we get the off-road tires. We'll be using the White Western Star for that. It's a very solid truck. One of my favorite trucks, actually, the White Western Star. It's a great truck. Hey, thank you for the follow. Olivia 990, thank you so much. I still gotta set up alerts. I gotta do that. Probably gonna do that this weekend. Ah, thank you. How are you doing this evening? Not too much. We're doing good. Just watching my stream. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate you tuning in. We're on our way to go steal some fuel from a trailer right now. Stream's going good. It's doing good so far. We're just kind of just getting rolling, so. Got a lot of stuff I want to get done. So hopefully we'll be able to get as much of that done as we can. Hey Cody, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Just playing a little Snowrunner right now. Just hauling some fuel trailers around at the moment. Trying to get started. Oh, this game is fantastic. How many games do I stream? I stream a lot of stuff. Mostly been streaming SnowRunner lately. Just having so much fun playing SnowRunner. Both on and off stream. You'll also catch me streaming a bunch of iRacing as well. I do a lot of racing simulations. And we're going to be ramping up the streaming with Armored Core 6 when that comes out. So I'm looking forward to that one. But that's kind of the main variety at the moment. Yeah, Cody, absolutely. This game is fantastic. It's challenging, it's fun to relax, and it's even got up to four player co-op as well. I know my dad and I, we get together several nights during the week, and we do some co-op SnowRunner together. We just kind of hit the trails and do some trucking together. It's a lot of fun. You also did streaming in 2020? Love to do stream? Yeah, streaming's fun. I've been at it for a while now. Just recently moved back over to Twitch. I was streaming on Glimish for a couple of years before that platform unfortunately closed. So we're kind of just, I've been at this for a couple of weeks now, so we're just kind of getting everything kind of together still. I'm missing alerts and stuff. Just smacked my truck on the concrete barriers. That's fun. I'm doing very well. I'm doing very good. Just having some fun chill. Yeah, I'm ready to get back racing with the league as well. Currently in Florida. That's where I'm at right now. Yeah. Just trying to stay out of the heat. I've been streaming for about 5 years now. Actively streaming for about 5 years, so it's something I like to do for fun. Yeah, thank you. It's been fun. No, thank you. I will pass on that one. Thank you. I appreciate the offer. I'm not interested in any work, any art. We are almost to the fuel station here. Yeah, likewise. Thanks for stopping by. Going to unwinch the truck here. See if we can hitch this trailer. Yeah, there we go. Heavy fuel tanker trailer. Let's fill up the Fleet Star. Fuel carrier trailer. We're gonna park this right here for now. Oh, there we go. Alright, we still got... I've got 700 gallons of fuel, or 700 liters, I should say, of fuel yet that we can work with on this. So we're going to leave that there for now. I'm going to grab this GMC. Just so we can get as much of that fuel as we can, I'm going to take the GMC, and I'm actually going to pull the Scout 800 with me as well. We're going to take these two trucks to the garage in Black River and get them outfitted. I want to put another fuel tanker on the GMC. That way we can move some more fuel around later. We're going to try to pull 700 liters out of that heavy fuel tank. And then once we get that done, we'll be moving the White Western Star over, and we're going to go deliver that big fuel tanker. I don't get stuck. Give me a little push there. Thank you. GMC does not like this mud here. Just going up that hill, it's a little tough. A little bit of traction. Come on. There we go. Right now we're just trying to get a little bit of setup done. Once we kind of get this setup done, then we're going to just start hammering out some contracts here, get some work done. Trying my best to kind of weave back and forth and avoid the soft ground in the middle. Thank you. Okay. You have a big engine in here. So we want another fuel tank. Probably would not hurt. Don't really need the race suspension. We're mostly going to be just using this for hauling fuel around. The scout, I am going to leave at the garage for now. We're going to do something else with that. Conveniently metal beams here, which I need. So we're gonna bring these with us. We're gonna go put some fuel in this truck. And then what I'm gonna do is, just to start off, we're gonna take the Fleet Star over to the warehouse, get some bricks, come back, grab the trailer, and go with the Fleet Star to deliver the two bricks and these metal beams. Once we get that delivered, we're gonna hop back over to Smithville, grab the white Western Star, which is already equipped with a high saddle, bring that over here, and move the fuel tanker. It's definitely slow going with this trailer, but we're getting there just slow and steady here. This would definitely be a lot easier if I wasn't pulling this trailer, but... It'll save me a trip to get some metal beams later by doing this. Oh, jeez. I'm gonna have to repair that later, but we're not gonna worry about that at the moment. We can dump the trailer there for now. Alright. Need... Oh, too much. Fill up 230 liters. So we'll just do it this way then. We'll do that. they gotta be 10%. Okay, so we have a lot of fuel here right now. Look, we're saving. So I'm going to hook up the Fleet Star and bring that trailer of beams right here. Then we're going to cross over here, grab bricks, come back, load the trailer up, go along this road here, and that will take us right to the factory. We're gonna go get some bricks. I'm gonna take just a short little break here real quick, so I will be right back, and then we'll go get the bricks and get this job done. See you in just a moment. back. Let's go get some bricks. Careful, we don't need to roll this thing. That would be a very big problem right now. All right, we got the bricks. We got our trailer with beams. And away we go. All right, we got bricks, we got metal beams. Let's go get this job done. Hauling cargo is so much more exciting than moving fuel trailers around. I like hauling cargo. I hit a rock. Here we are at our destination. Okay, so now I just need to pull the heavy fuel tanker. So we're gonna head over to Smithville and grab the White Western Star. It's already outfitted with the high saddle. And we're gonna go pull this heavy fuel tanker. A little bit of frame rate lag there with the saving, but we are all good. Ooh, one thing I didn't think about, I hope I can still hook up to this trailer even with the crane equipped. If not, it's a short drive to the garage to unequip the crane. Not a big deal. I should be able to, though. I like honking the horn. Quamp. Quamp. Makes the birds fly around too, which is kind of cool. Cool, we can attach this. Oh, I should have grabbed a photo mode shot over there with the trucks. All right, here we go. Taking a lot of damage on these rocks here. Gotta be a little more careful. Oh, I forgot to paint my GMC orange. Oh well. That'll be okay. Another nice thing about draining all the fuel out of this is not only do I get to keep the fuel when the job is done, but the tanker's a lot lighter too. It doesn't have the fuel in it. Okay, that is done. Now we've got not a drill, two metal beams, a drill rig drill in the construction rig semi-trailer over here for the drilling site. So, before we do that, let's customize our scout here. Let's put the opera tires on it, I think. Raise suspension kit on this thing. That is a mistake. Actually, do want this. I want the autonomous winch, but cannot risk that expense at the moment. So what we're going to do here, there's a job that we picked up. Let me track it. Local entertainment. We're going to do that. We're going to grab this watchtower, and then there's a contest here to basically hit 3 waypoints. So we're going to try to get that done because we do need the scout for that, or a scout, rather. And then pretty much everything else in Black River can be done with the big trucks. I do want to, there is an upgrade I want to grab on the way over there. So we're going to grab that upgrade. There we go, we're all loaded up on fuel here. Try to go down there and go get that engine down there. Alright, yeah, that is my big truck engine. That's good. We needed that. We still need 650 XP to hit rank 8. See if we can get that by doing a couple of these jobs here. Oh, okay. I didn't want to have to do that, but that was a nasty hit. We're gonna do that one soon. Those crates. That'll be a job for the fleet star since it's up here. Gotta get to these barrels. Oh, this is gonna be fun. Pretty sure I can go there, get to that one, and then come back. No, not there. Down here to get that one. Come back up, then. The Bravo barrels are the tough one. You gotta go around up this rock path here to get those. So let's start with these. Main thing here is I gotta do my best not to flip over. Kind of wish I was using the Chevy right now. Scouts, what we got. This is a very sketchy task. Alright, so far so good. Okay. Oh no, oh no, oh. Are we good? We're good? No. Oh. God, no. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. That's alright. Okay. I'm gonna go use the fleet star to kick the other barrels over, and then we'll go flip the scout over. Yeah, that set of barrels on the rocks are just, it's just so sketchy trying to do those. There's just nowhere to really get turned around and back out of there properly. Just kind of thought we were going to land on our top, but we did not. just need 470 more XP. So we're going to do this missing machinery job now. I've ever used this road before. That's been a while since I've actually used it. Probably gonna need a little bit of fuel while I'm working over here, but I think we'll be okay for now. I can probably nap the fuel off the scout. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna flip the scout over, we'll refuel it, and then fill up the fleet star. Because I'm not gonna need all that fuel for the next job I had in mind for the scout 800. I'm gonna get those two crates, but I wanna go get the scout flipped first while I'm up here. Get that rescued. Hey, Accursed Sword. Welcome. I would be down for that another time. I am trying to do a hard mode playthrough at the moment, so I'm trying to figure out the planning and all that and try to do these maps in hard mode for the first time. I've played through them on normal. I've just never done hard mode before, but I completely appreciate the offer. Yeah, we're doing good so far. Kind of been bouncing back and forth between Black River and Smithville, just trying to do some safe jobs that I'm able to do. I just finished draining and turning in that heavy fuel tanker mission, so we got that all drained so I can use that fuel. Right now, we're just trying to just kind of clean up Black River a little bit. So, how are you doing? Good to see you. Hope you're having a great day. Oh, very nice. Well, thank you for stopping by the stream. I really appreciate it. It sounds like you know quite a bit about Snowrunner. So let me show you kind of my planning we got here. So I've got the Scout up here, the Scout 800. I just finished doing the knock the barrels job over. Rolled it, had to go fix it. So my next job with the Scout, I'm going to do this meteorology data contest. I've got the White Western Star over here because I just finished hauling that fuel tanker trailer. We've got down here, I've got the Transtar and the GMC and a fuel tank. This is kind of my fuel operation to drain that trailer. So that's kind of where we have everything stationed. And my Chevy is over in Smithville Dam. Ran out of fuel somewhere, so it's not like a super high priority to go get that rescued. But we are at, I got 37% of Michigan done already so far. On hard mode, feeling really good about that. Oh, it is. It just the slightest thing, and it just goes over, and it's just like, oh man. But at the same time, it's like it's such a wildly fun truck to drive, or a Jeep, whatever. It's so fun to just drive that thing around, but yeah, it's the top heavy. I've decided like I never put the race suspension on it just because that just makes it so worse. Oh, you're talking about the Lodestar? I love the Lodestar. That is my favorite Scout. It's actually a toss-up between that and the F750. Those are kind of my two go-to Scouts. On my normal playthrough that I've got going. I love those trucks. I think I've been thinking, I think the Lodestar is gonna be my first like truck purchase for hard mode, just because I know at that point like I'll have my scouts covered. Like I won't have to worry about scouting at all. So I definitely want to get the Lodestar. as soon as I'm able to, because I love that thing. That's a great truck. All right, we got two more drilling parts to rescue. Yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate you stopping by. Hope you're enjoying the stream. Hey, thank you for the follow. I really appreciate that. Go around the bend here, I should be able to get down in there with those two parts. We were able to get enough fuel out of the scout as well, so we're good there. Here we go. Because those are right down there. Ah, fell off. Should have put that on there better. Ding. If I just keep going this way. Right down to the drilling site. does. And we can just get right back on the road and get these parts dropped off. Cargo has arrived. Alright. So that pretty much clears up a lot of this. What do we got? We got stuck trailer. That one won't be too terrible. That's on the other side of the map, so we gotta drive a ways to get to that one. That one won't be that bad. Missing oil tank. That's over there. That is one last mission trailer. I'm going to want to wait until I have the off-road tires for that one, because that oil tanker is in some pretty deep mud. And that will be a job for the White Western Star. There's a couple of stuck trucks. There's a truck there, a truck here. We got one more watchtower to get. And then there's a truck back here. And that is also for part of this job. Drainage, get to the pump, get the truck out. Those I want to wait until I get the off-road tires to do. Logging. I have no intention of starting logging yet. So the only contract we really have to work on is not a drill. What I do want to do... Meteorology data... 220 XP, $3,800, which that will actually get us to rank 8 there by doing this contest. So we're going to go do the contest to get to these three weather sensors. That's what we're going to do next. And then after that, I am going to take the White Western Star. We'll leave the Fleet Star where it is for now. We'll take the White Western Star and go to the garage, grab the off-road tires, and put the bigger engine in it that I just got. And we're gonna go see if we can get some of these oil tanks and stuff. But before we do that, I'm gonna step away for just a moment. And I will be right back. Back. Okay, so those are our 3 points. So I'm gonna plot us a route. There we go, we got us a route. So we gotta drive this in first person. So away we go. Thank you. Alright, we got one more to go. Oh, we did it! Note to self, next time I do that, there's a road here I can just use. But hey, we got rank 8. Well, that's pretty cool. Well, there is, at this point in time, no more scouting stuff. But there's the one watchtower here. But that is the last bit of scouting stuff to do in Black River. So I think I might save that for next time. But what I might do is start my journey into Smithville with the Scout 800. And go refuel and rescue Machete. think that's what we might do next. Let's go do that. Let's go get that last watchtower. Hey. I'm just gonna go park this where I might need it next, which is just a spot to take it into Smithville next time we go to Smithville. So we do not need it here. Over the concrete barrier. That's a wonderful idea. All right, we're going to take these guys and reconvene with the fleet. Yo, Lee! Welcome to the stream. How you doing? Good to see ya. We're just playing a little Snowrunner right here. Awesome. Glad to hear it. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that word, but I know what it means, so thank you. I know I'm just going to mispronounce it and it's going to sound terrible. S-crack. Okay, scrack. There we go. Was that right? You know, you got me trying to pronounce the word. All right. Scrack. There we go. But yeah, we're just we're playing a little Snowrunner right now. We just got the big rank 8 upgrade. Doing pretty good. Really good, actually. You know, I've been playing Snowrunner for like a year and a half now. I love playing Snowrunner, but this is really the first time I've been like, you know what, we're gonna do a streaming. Sorry, my sinuses just immediately drained into my throat in the middle of a sentence. That was really painful. But anyway, I'm doing good. I've never done a full SnowRunner series before, and I decided I was pretty far along in my regular game mode. I had a lot of experience doing some co-op maps, so I was like, I want to try SnowRunner's hard mode, but I want to turn it into a content series. So yeah, we're getting a pretty good fleet together at the moment. I got these two big boys right now. We just finished doing some work, so I'm taking them back to the fleet so that we can prep them for the next set of jobs. But yeah, I wanted to really try to tackle the hard mode, which is a lot of money and fuel management, because you have to pay for fuel, you have to pay for repairs. It's extremely costly to recover your trucks if something goes wrong. So, as just like a general rule, I am not doing any auto recoveries. I am doing my best to You know, if I get a truck turned sideways, I'm going to get another truck out there. We're going to flip it upside down and right side up and get it back going again. So, kind of like a hardcore playthrough right now. We're just trying to get things going. Story of your life. Well, I hope you're not flipping trucks upside down. That would be terrible. But yeah, like I've actually been having a lot of fun. It takes like your regular, you know, go here, point A to point B, drop cargo off, move the trailers here, to a lot more micromanaging and just making sure that your fuel is in strategic places so that you don't run out and can still get the work done. So I've actually been just like, it's been an absolute thrill so far. Reapproaching Michigan's, you know, starter zone, starter map, and just with that hardcore, more realism, I want to say, aspect of it. Yeah, that is the sim racer in me for sure. The sim racer in me also likes to drive these trucks as fast as I can sometimes, and that does not end well. Snowrunner does not end well when you drive really, really fast, because then you're rolling your trucks upside down all the time, which is not good at all. Speaking of sim racing, what do you think of that that Progeny announcement there? Representing Team Progeny on the sim racing side of things. Working on a paint scheme right now with my painter, so we'll have that going. Then pesky right turns, yeah. We're getting pretty good at the right turns, but left turning is still my specialty. Yeah, absolutely. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a lot of fun. Yeah, because, Lee, you and I have been talking for a long time now. It's like, oh, we got to go run an endurance race together. We've never been able to get it together, so it's going to be fun. I think that opportunity is close at hand now for us to be able to go race together here pretty soon. It's going to be fun. Hello, fleet. As you can see, this is my fuel fleet here. So here's what we got right now for the fuel fleet. We've got, I got this GMC here. All right, so this fuel tank is now empty, which I actually have something I want to use this for while it's empty. So I'm actually going to park you right here for now, because I'm actually gonna, there's a fuel trailer here missing oil tank, so whenever I get around to recovering this, that has to be delivered here to the fuel station, so I'm gonna just steal all the fuel out of it with the GMC before we actually turn that in. So, and then I've got my cab over truck here, a Transtar. And this is my big fuel convoy here. Should be able to, yeah, we'll fill up with the trailer. And we're gonna park that there. Now that we're topped off on fuel. Yeah, we absolutely do gotta map it out now. For sure. So I'm gonna take these crazy boys over to the garage. These are my two workhorses right here, the Fleet Star and the White Western Star. They're the stars of the show. Okay, now I can put these awesome, epic UOD 2 tires on this thing. And we're going to throw this bigger engine in it. Hey, no worries, Lee. I was actually just about to wrap up stream soon anyway, so I'm glad I caught you for a little bit here. No, we'll leave you with the saddle pie for now. That's fine. Throw that engine in there. All right, Lee, we'll catch you later. Thanks for stopping by. All right, there we go. Everyone, thank you so much for joining me for SnowRunner today. We got a lot done. We went from 34% to 39%. Only 5%, but we got some big stuff done. We basically have cleared up this entire north section of Michigan. We got to do a few more trips to the factory. So next time on stream, we are going to work on not a drill. We're going to work on that and see what we got to do for that. Until then, thank you all for hanging out. We are making some fantastic progress on hard mode here. And now that we have the off-road tires, the map is mine to command. We can basically do almost everything on the map with those off-road tires. Basically everything we can get done. So I'm looking forward to cleaning up Black River. On the next stream, we're going to go rescue a bunch of trucks and trailers and just have a lot of fun doing that. And then we're going to kind of keep working through and try to raise the funds we need so that we can start looking at logging at some point. I don't want to save logging to the very end, but we're going to keep working on it. So thank you all for hanging out. Thank you all for watching. We had a great stream today. If you're watching this on YouTube, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. And I will see you guys at the next one. Bye-bye.